Hey guys, today I'm going to guide you through the process that I underwent while taking the screenshots that you're seeing right now. I'm going to show you everything from the setup, to selection, to editing, and finally posting. Now I can already tell you that most of the stuff I'm going to talk about is probably common knowledge to most of you, but I didn't want to leave anyone out, so I'm going to try to make this as elaborate and basically as dumbed down as I possibly can. But for now, let's make sure that you have these four things before we get started. Number one, you're going to need to have some software with screen capturing capabilities. Some people use GameCam or Cam Studio. Those are both fine, but for this example, I'm going to be using Fraps. If you're not sure where to find any of these, just try Google. Number two, you're going to need some software to edit your screenshots. There are plenty of choices out there. And again, Google can help you if you're not sure, but for this video, I'm going to be using Photoshop CS3. Third, you'll need a place to store your screenshots on the internet, and not surprisingly, there are tons of choices available. There's Flickr, there's ImageShack, the list goes on, but personally, I prefer photobucket.com. And lastly, of course, you're going to need MX vs. ATV Unleashed for the PC. Now, in the game itself, you may notice a few modifications that I'm using. Those are .pack files, and at the end of the video, I'll go through and I'll list all those, just in case you're interested in downloading them. Anyway, I think that covers just about everything, so let's go ahead and get started. First of all, you want to get Fraps set up to your advantage. Now, the way I do that is to open it up, click the Screenshots tab, and then enable the option to repeat screen captures every 1 second. Now obviously this means you're going to have a lot of screenshots to go through, but it also means that your chances for getting a good one are that much higher, so I think it's worth it. You can also change the format that the screenshots are saved in, but I just keep it on BMP. The next step is arguably the most important, and that is to set up your video card for optimal quality. Typically video cards are set up for optimal performance, which generally translates into some crappy looking screenshots. Unfortunately, I can't really tell you how to adjust your video card. You're really gonna have to figure that out for yourself, but I will show you how I adjust mine, and hopefully that will help you to figure out yours. My video card is made by ATI, first of all, and all I have to do is right click on my desktop and choose Catalyst Control Center from the menu that drops down. From there, I choose the 3D portion of the menu, go to All Settings, and max out all the sliders and check any of the boxes that I feel need to be checked. Now, additionally, I can see all of this in graphical form, if I want to, by clicking on some of these options on the side menu here. Alright, since we've got these things taken care of, we can go ahead and fire up the game now. Alright, here we are at the main menu. But before we go any further, you want to make sure that the game itself is set up to display at its highest quality. So let's go to the Options menu, choose Video Options, and make sure that your resolution is at its highest possible setting and that Dynamic Shadows and Environment Mapping are both on. Next, you want to eliminate some of the unnecessary junk that can really clutter up your screenshots. So we'll start there with the jukebox. You want to go through this entire list, hit the X key to uncheck each song, and whenever you reach the bottom of the list, hit Enter. Okay, after you've loaded up the track that you're wanting to write on, go ahead and pause the game, go into Overlay Options, and make sure that everything is turned off. Now, after you turn everything off, if your gamepad suddenly stops working, then go back into Overlay Options and choose to leave the preload meter on. And at the end of this video, I will tell you where to find a .pack file that actually makes that preload meter invisible. Alright, you saw that my video card settings were at optimal quality just a minute ago, but sometimes, for whatever reason, it'll revert itself back to optimal performance, and it's something that I don't necessarily notice until I exit the game and start looking at my screenshots. So to make sure that doesn't happen, what I do is I pan the camera around and I look very closely at the rear fender, and if I see any jagged edges there at all, then I know that personally for my video card, that is not optimal quality. But fortunately, as you can tell, there are no jagged edges, so I am good to go. The thrill cam and the look back cam are pretty important. I usually use those in conjunction with the main camera angle, But I do recommend that you download a pack to replace all the default camera views, since there's really only so much you can do with those. Today I'm going to be using the camera pack made by Shadow. It's really good, so check it out if you haven't already. Also, I have a gamepad, like I said, and I've got it set up so that the throw cam and the look back cam are assigned to triggers on the top of the controller. That really comes in handy. Now, you want to move the camera around a lot to try and get a good angle. I even move it around while I'm in the air in hopes of capturing something good. Also, let me explain that whenever I set out to take screenshots, that's really all I'm going for is a good shot. You know, videos are different, but for screenshots, it doesn't matter how many times I crash. I just want to get the shot. Back to the desktop now, as you can see, and it's time to go through our shots and see what all we've got. Like I was saying earlier, whenever you set up Fraps to take a shot every 1 second, naturally you're going to have a lot to go through. So in this case, we're looking at about 1100 shots, which is going to take me a while. Okay, now what I do is I open up the first one, and then I use the down arrow on my keyboard to go through the rest of them as fast as I possibly can until I find one that catches my eye. Now, that doesn't always happen. You know, sometimes I'll take a whole round of shots and it'll all be for nothing. But hopefully that's not the case this time. Actually, wait a minute. Yeah, I like that shot. I think we'll go ahead and open this one up in Photoshop and we can edit it later on, but for now we're just going to set it off to the side and get back to the rest of our shots.